If your knees are a little bit buggy or if the hips are super tight, you may want to sit on the block. It helps a little bit to tilt the pelvis forward. And then you're going to cross your legs. And this is Stretchy Sunday. This is this yoga practice is based on the yin concept of yoga. Good morning. Slow body movement, very intentional slow body movement, and attention to breathing. Now, the idea here is the concept of it, is to connect to our breathing, keep our nervous system calm while we go into some of potentially deeper postures and positions. Yeah, grab a strap there on top. Good stuff. Most of these body movements should be accessible to most of us in various forms. The intensity level, we want to keep it low to about maybe 4 or 5 out of 10, 10 being the most. And then we'll just play with different body positions. Okay. So sitting up tall, wherever you happen to be on the block or not, just allow the groin space here to settle and let the knees fall off to the side. You can rest the arms onto your legs. And if you feel comfy closing your eyes or just making your eyes a little bit heavy, go ahead and do that. And let's just focus our attention on our breathing by breathing in through the nose. Nice big breath coming in. Take it deep into your belly. Hold your breath when your lungs are full. And then a long exhale to follow. This seated cross-legged position is considered one of the optimal body positions for full breathing. It allows the diaphragm to just get really deep here and expanding the ribs and rib cage and lung expansion as well. Only one thing to do, focus on breathing. Every inhale, just notice the breath get a little bit deeper, a little bit longer. You want to fill up that belly area first before you fill up the chest. Many of us are chest breathers. We want to switch that up into more of a belly breath. You're going to open your eyes. Let's just do some slow head circles. Turn your head to your right. It'll be my left. And keep on turning your head as far as you can go. Keep going, keep going. Come back to center. Turn your head to the other side. It's a nice big stretch here. Come back to center. Lift your head straight up. Look up. And stay in this position and drop the ear from side to side. Come to neutral, chin to chest. And then you drop the ear to side, right and left. A nice and slow movement. You want to stretch this out. Stuff. Come back to that neutral position. You're going to take that right hand over onto your left knee, left arm back. A little bit of rotational movement. Look past the left shoulder. Keep your rib cage turning to the left, but turn your head to the right side. So you're going to go the opposite side for the head turn here. Maybe close your eyes and just stretch this out as you go in the opposite direction of the torso. Now relax, come back to neutral position. You're going to switch, do the other side. Left hand over there. And we switch into a rotation. Look past the right shoulder. Sit up nice and tall, everyone. So you're turning the torso and head to the right. And then you're going to turn your head to the left. Opposite direction. Thank you. Thanks, Deck. We've got some grinding going on here. And then back to center position. Okay, I'm going to get off the block extend the legs straight. We're going to do that same rotational movement in just 1 second. And first, we're just going to lean forward. So lift the arms up and overhead. Take a nice big breath as you look up. And think about hinging at the hip crease without rounding the spine. Hinge forward as much as you can. If you want to bend the knees slightly, it's totally cool to do that. And then you're going to bring your hands down, arms down. Try and lean forward, stretch out the hamstrings, lower back as well. It doesn't really matter how close the chest comes to thighs. Close your eyes. Feel the sensation of the stretch, regardless of how close you are. It's more about the sensation, less body movement. Come back up, cross the left leg over the right, hold on to that left leg, and we're going to do a rotation again the other direction, and this can be a little bit more intense. Keep on going as far as you can go, and then again, you're going to turn their head to the other side, so opposite side. Come back to neutral, switch it up, this side. And you're trying to sit up fairly tall here so that you can rotate and twist through a straight spine. Every time you exhale, you should be able to go a little bit deeper into your twist. And then when the torso and head can't go anymore, you're going to turn the head to the opposite side. Keep the legs crossed, come back to neutral, just cross the leg. Try and keep this right knee down. So you see, I'm really tight, my knee pops up. I'm gonna try and keep this knee down, flex both feet, lift the arms right back up again, take a big breath, and then fold one more time with one leg crossed. Any amount, and then you can hold on to your leg here as you hinge forward. So typically the lower back and right outer glute is where you're gonna feel this. Lift your chest up. Okay, now we're going to hold on to this leg. So hold on, right hand onto the right knee, left hand onto your right foot. Lift the leg up, and then just do some rotational movements of any kind. You can bring the leg in really tight, let it go a little bit, do some circles. Even hold on to the leg more in front this way and open the leg up a little bit. And you can hold both hands onto the right foot and discover any range of motion. So if you get to a spot where you're really tight, hang out there a little bit. Try and move into it just a little bit more if you're super tight. And release it, and let's switch it up and do the other side. Left over the right. Always good to notice the difference whenever we do anything left and right, just to see what the difference in your body is. So again, my knee is, my hip is tight, the leg shoots up. I want to press down a little bit. And straight spine, and then we hinge forward. Whoa, I really feel it quite a bit more on this one side. Again, you flex both feet, send your chest forward. And I'm going to pick up the leg, hold on to it in any fashion, and then move that around a little bit. Test out your range of motion. I'm going to hold on to the leg with both hands and move that around a bit more. Okay, good stuff. Release the leg, lie down onto your back. Hold on to your knees. Rock your shape a little bit side to side. Drop the head down, maybe close your eyes. Should feel pretty good. A massage on the lower back. Right back into that deep breathing. In and out through the nose. See if we can grab onto the outer edges of your feet. Keep your tailbone down. It's like a squatting position, but in a supine body position. Rock side to side. If you're super tight, you can just hold onto your shins, lower the legs a little bit so that the tailbone is not up in the sky. Okay, so you want the tailbone down. As the legs go out, and you rock side to side. Bring your feet to the floor. You're going to cross the right leg over the left. Hold on to the back of the left leg, flex both feet, and draw the left leg back. What you're trying to do here is push the right knee away as you draw the left leg back a little bit more. Bring your left foot to the floor. Take the arms to the side in a T shape, palms face down, press down into the floor so the shoulders stay down. Take a breath. When you exhale, drop your legs to the left side, turn your head to the right side, and we'll do a rotation, twisting movement. Any amount, keep your shoulders down. Try and keep those shoulders really relaxed here. Make it a lower body movement. Close your eyes, breathe deeply. Every time you exhale, you're going to draw the abs in, creating a bit more room for a twist. Take a deep breath in. Hold your breath. Bring your legs back. As you exhale, keep your legs crossed and drop them to the other side. Turn the head to the opposite side. Inhale it back to center position. We're going to cross the legs the other way, left over the right. Hold on to the back of the right leg. Draw the leg up. So you're pressing the left knee away as the right knee is getting closer to your chest. Bring the right foot down, arms to T-shape, palms face down. Take a breath in, drop the legs to the right, turn your head to the left. And big inhale, big breath comes in. Hold your breath, bring your legs to center. Drop them to the other side as you turn your head to the opposite side. Opposite direction for rotation and twist. Inhale back to center, uncross your legs, grab the strap, you guys, and for those of you at home, if you don't have a strap, use a towel. You can put the strap underneath the right foot. Now, you don't want to choke up here, so we're not going to hold the strap too high. It's going to be down more at the bottom. Bend the right elbow and bring the arm down, so the right arm comes down. Extend the left leg, or you can keep it bent a little bit. And then what you're going to do is take the left hand off to the side, drop your leg over to the right side, and hold on to that leg with the strap and arm strength. So bicep strength here. And let the leg just fall off to the right side. Now, if you're super tight, you'll notice that the groin is very, very tight, and you will not be able to release the leg. But you're trying to release it. When I first started doing this, I was so tight that if I let the strap go, my leg would just kind of hang out. The idea is that if you let the strap go, the leg's going to drop. So find that position where it's completely tension-free through the inner leg, and let the strap just hold on to the weight. Take a nice big breath in, bring the leg back to center. Hold. Left hand now is going to hold on to the strap. Drop the leg to the other side, left, and turn your head to the right side. So the right hip is turning, the right butt cheek lifts up. Rotation, supported rotation with the strap here. Start to breathe in, nice big breath, bring your leg back to center. Hold on the strap with the left hand, switch your feet. So you're gonna put the left foot in, take the right foot out. And then we switch and do this opposite side. We drop the leg to the left side, turn the head to the right side. And try and relax through the inside of the leg all the way up into the groin. Just let the bicep strength hold the weight from the leg. Take a breath, bring your leg back, hold on to the strap with the right hand this time. Rotation, so the left leg goes to the right and your head's going to turn to the left, keep the left shoulder down. Take a breath and come back to that neutral position. Okay, gonna move the strap out of the way. Grab your block. Bend your legs, press your feet into the floor, and you're gonna lift your hips up and bring the block underneath the sacrum, which is the flat part of the pelvis. And then we're gonna take the legs up. And look at the angle of the femur here. It's tilted towards the back. And I'm going to extend the legs, trying to just hang out in this position, arms to the side. So your legs should just naturally hold here in this position. So the angle is the legs going back a little bit towards the chest, and then the block supporting the weight underneath your lower back. Start to take the legs apart, a little bit wider. flex your feet. Go as wide as you can go. You can hold on to your legs too if you like, at the lower leg. Just try and take the legs super wide here. Rock a little bit side to side. It's a calming effect. So if the groin space is tight, it may resist. Close your eyes. Try and soften through that space again, that groin space. Take the legs as wide as you can go. Rock your shape side to side. Okay, I'm going to bring the legs a little bit closer together. Next movement here is a little bit more active. So I'm going to take the hands to the floor and lift the hips up even more. What I'm going to try and do is bring my toes behind my head. Okay? Toes behind the head, any amount. Keep your neck really long. Just go as far as you can go. Watch the intensity of the position. It could get pretty intense. So pull back. Just find a level that 4 or 5 out of 10. Slowly come back down. Pelvis back onto the block. And this time you're going to extend the legs straight out and down to the floor. So heels touch down, but take the legs a little bit wider. And this will lengthen out the top of the thighs. If you want a little bit more intensity, you can lift the hips up, change the orientation of the block so it's higher, and then extend the legs. Bend your legs, bring your feet to the floor, press your hips up, move the block out of the way. Drawing both knees into chest, come on up into a little ball here, just rock your shape side to side as a counter movement. And then you're going to come up into a seated position. Okay, come on up into 90-90 leg position. So you bend both legs to 90-90. Good stuff. Yep. Flex your feet. Sit up tall. Excuse me. And then hinge your shape forward. So you're going to bring your chest close to your thighs. Hold on to your legs if you like. Try and hinge forward. So in this position, the right knee is pushing down into the floor, the left knee is also pressing down into the floor, and the upper body is creating this rotational movement to get square with the hips, shoulders and hips square. Okay, now you're going to lift your chest up. So again, heads up, the right knee is pushing down, the left knee is pushing down, and now you're going to try and lie back. As far as you can go without the legs lifting. You lie back, take the arms behind you, lie back, There you go. You type. Kaylin can just go because she's super bendy. Except her left knee's off the floor. There's no right or wrong way to do this. You're just trying to get into it. So this is more of a quad stretch here on the right side. As far back as you can go. And slowly come on up. Keep your leg position. And in this leg shape, we're going to do a rotation. So you're going to rotate to the left. And when you can't go anymore, the head turns to the right. So it goes to the opposite side. And then coming back to neutral, we're going to lift both knees up. Take the hands behind you. And from here, we're just going to try and drop one knee in. Try not to turn the whole body here. So all you're trying to do is just turn one leg in for an internal leg rotation. Open it up and do the other side. And again, notice left and right differences from one side to the next. Switch. And this time, go a little bit so you can turn the torso so you can keep going all the way. Notice how much the upper body has to compensate for the right knee to come down. And when the right knee is down, you're going to try and pull that right shoulder back. Trying to sit up a little more here. Ooh, awkward. And then up. And I'm going to try and get the left knee down. Keep going, keep going, keep going as far as you need to go. And once it's down, you bring the right knee back up and then the left shoulder back out. Come back to neutral. Extend both legs straight. My arms are behind me, so I'm going to bring the hands a little closer to the butt, extend the arms, and now I'm going to use the arms to press me forward. Keep looking at your toes, flex your foot, and then press your upper body forward. Come up one more time. Okay, you're going to cross the left leg over the right, bend the right leg as well, arms behind you. So I'm going to just, this is my position, this is how I get into it. Oh, super tight. Whew. Okay, so I'm going to flex the left foot here and I'm pressing myself forward while I'm trying to get the left knee away. And then you can temper this so you can go forward and back a little bit. Breathe. I've gone a little over the 4 or 5 out of 10 on my intensity. This is pretty intense here. So, any amount. And I'm just going to loosen a little bit. So, I'm going to pull the butt back just a little bit, adjust my position, and then drop the legs to one side. Turn the head to the opposite side. Come back to center. Again, drop the leg to the other side, head to the other side. And then we come up and we'll just switch the legs. Okay, right over left. Okay, and then scooch in whatever position you need to get to. There we go. Try and take the chest a little bit more forward, flex the foot, And the right outer hip space right here is where you want to feel most of this. So if you're feeling it on the inside, you got some pinchy stuff going on, you want to feel it more out here. And if it is pinchy, then maybe a little bit of work on that inside. And you can rock a little bit side to side. Close your eyes. And I'm going to drop the legs to the left. Turn the head to the right. And switch, legs to the other side, head to the opposite side. And again, back to center, uncross your legs, good stuff. Okay, we're gonna move into frog position. Again, staying with the hips. Let's switch it up. We won't do frog just yet. We'll go into child's pose first. Take your knees wide. Bring your toes to touch behind you at the back. So the big toes touch. And then you're going to press your butt back. Try and touch the butt towards your heels as much as you can. I can't go back all the way. I've got compression issues in this knee. My knee just will not allow this movement. So I can do a certain amount. And then once you're there, reach the arms forward, bring your head down, bring your chest down, and keep extending arms forward to get some length through the underarms. If your hands are on the floor like this, like mine are, just push back so you can get those hips back as far as you can, and then bring the chest and head down. And settle into the shape. Breathe deeply. Lift your head and chest up a little bit. You're going to take the left arm, tuck it underneath you. Get the left hand going to the right, and then take the chest back down again and try and get onto the outside of the left shoulder. Lift the chest up, take the arm out, and switch the arms. Left arm forward, right arm tucks under. Drop the chest down again, try and get to the outside of the right shoulder. Going to bring the chest back up again. Take the arm out. Right arm extends forward. And let's just shift our body weight front to back a little bit. So you're going to bring your knees in a bit more. Press the pelvis to the floor. Roll the shoulders back. Look up. So a bit of a back bend here. When you're in this position, turn your head side to side. So at no point should you feel this in your lower back. If you are, the abdominal muscles need to engage, okay? So you got to protect your lower back at this position as you rotate the head side to side. Again, press your way back. Keep the arms forward. Reach elbows off the floor. And one more time. Come on forward. So abs are tight here. And as I press in a bit of an arch, look up, turn your head side to side. Okay, now we're gonna come down onto our elbows, so forearms, point your toes. Light pressure into the hands and forearms, lift the chest up. Close your eyes, turn your head from side to side. Okay, you're gonna come back to neutral. I'm gonna extend the right arm forward, bend the left leg. Hold on at the shin, so you're going to flex the foot. You're not pointing your toes here, you're flexing the foot. Right arm forward, and then you're going to tug onto that left leg for a bit of a quad stretch on this one side. Lower the leg down and switch. Left arm goes forward, bend the right leg, hold on to the shin, foot flexion, and then again you pull on a little bit and reach forward. Head down. Let go of that right leg. You're going to bring the right knee up to your side now, so that right leg comes up to the side. Take the left arm off to the side as well. So what's happening here is the left arm is pushing down. The right knee is also pushing down. I'm going to bend the left leg and hold on to that leg with the right hand. Flex the foot. Now keep turning your breastbone, the center of your chest, to the ceiling. So you're turning up. Nice. Look up to the ceiling, all the way to the right side. Let go of the leg, bring your chest down. We're going to switch the position. So this time the left leg goes up, left leg up this way, right arm off to the side. So your left knee is pushing down, right arm is pushing down. You're going to bend the right leg, hold on to the shin on that right side, lift your head up and turn the rib cage to the left, turn your head to the left. And I come back to neutral position. Okay, let's activate the back muscles just a tiny little bit. Extend your legs. Arms are going to be by your side. You're going to look down onto the floor and try and lift.
I'm going to try and lift the chest away from the floor. And your legs
away from the floor. So just lift up a little bit. Engage muscles. And then lower down. Cycle through a couple of those. Lift up, contract all the muscles in your back to get that nice big lift, and soften to lower down. try and get as much of range of motion as you can. So the front of your body is lifting off the floor, and then you lower it down. We do this slowly with intention to strengthen the back. Up and down. Do one more. And now we're going to try and get into floor bow, which is both legs bend, hold on to the shin, flex your feet. Now, if the knees start to go really, really wide, try and bring the knees back a little bit, look down, and then lift the chest up as you press your legs into your hands. And think about a bow position. So this is floor bow in yoga. Keep looking down to the floor. Lift the chest up, not the head. And turn your head to the left. Turn your head to the right, nice and slow. And release the position altogether. Crocodile or alligator pose in yoga is one hand on top of the other. You're going to turn your feet in so the inside of your feet are touching the floor. And notice if the heels are high, that's typically we're tight. So I'm going to bring the forehead down just to rest in this position. And just drop one knee. One heel. One heel to touch the floor a little bit at a time. And if you're super bendy and really open through the hip, you can bring your heels almost to touch behind you as you drop them from side to side. Okay, and we'll stop that. And we're going to bring the hands just in front here into the side a little bit, elbows up high. A little bit of pressure into the hands as you lift up the chest. And when you come down, you're going to push the right shoulder forward. Look past your left shoulder to the ceiling. So press the right shoulder forward. Stretch out that shoulder. Take your time. Breathe in and out a couple of times. And then you come right back up into neutral position and switch to the other side. Then you stay there for two or three breaths. And we get back to neutral, other side. Again, noticing the shoulder tightness from one side. This is internal rotation. For some of us, it could be tight. Switch it up again, one more time. Do a couple times each side. Nice breathing, you guys. I hear some nice breathing going on here. Stay with your deep breath in and out. Come back through center. Okay, we're going to get onto that shoulder again. If you haven't done this one before, nice and slow, arms to the side. I'm going to roll onto my left shoulder. Take the right foot, right leg behind. You can bring your head down. You can leave your head up. You can also grab onto the back of the right leg for a quad stretch. And if that right knee's gone really high, you may want to lower it down just a little bit and draw the leg back. Inhale to release the position. Come back to neutral. Again, you're going to T-shape those arms out. Move on to your right shoulder. Right side. Left leg goes back. Hold on to the left leg. optional. If it's too intense, don't bother. Just roll onto that shoulder, look up at the ceiling. Come back onto the belly. And now we're gonna move into frog, so come on up. Okay, let's cue this up. Frog position, deep into the hips. You're gonna take the knees wide, turn the feet in, and the heel is in line with the knee, so the heels are not close together, they're more far apart. The further back you sit, the more you're gonna feel it. The further forward you sit, the less you're gonna feel it. So start to make your way back until you feel that 4 or 5 out of 10. Once you're there, let's bring the elbows down and rest and relax into the position. Close your eyes and breathe deeply. We're gonna stay in here for about 90 seconds. And then we're gonna come forward, take a little bit of a 30 or about a 15 second break, and then we go back maybe a little bit deeper the second time. We're gonna do 3 rounds of this. Nice and slow, no speedy way of getting into the deep hip opener. And find that point of tension that's about a 4 or 5 out of 10. Breathe into wherever you feel the tension. Exhale out of wherever you feel tension. Try and create this mind-body connection through our breathing as the conduit. Another 30 seconds. Start to shift your weight forward so you're coming out of tension now. Walk the elbows forward a little bit. Let the blood flow go back into that space. And you're going to close your eyes, walk the elbows back. And find that point where you're challenging the position and posture. Close your eyes. And then fuel the discomfort with your breathing. Another 30 seconds. Walk your elbows forward a bit. Back to zero tension. Catch your breath here. Blood flow go back. And one final round for about 90 seconds or so. Walk the elbows back, maybe noticing even if you can go back a bit deeper. Back into your deep breathing, everyone. Still stay with that deep breath. Maybe even count in for 4 or 5 seconds. Hold for the count of 2 seconds. Exhale for 4 or 5 seconds. Hold with empty lungs for a second or two, and then repeat the cycle. A great way to stay present is to count your breathing. Stay focused on your breathing, you'll stay present. Keep the body shape where it is, challenge the position. And walk the elbows forward as we come out of frog. I'm going to come up into more of a tabletop position now. Bring the knees in a bit closer. Wrists underneath the shoulders. I'm just going to move that around. Oh, all that stuff. Woohoo! Get all the chunky monkey hip stuff going. Both directions. Nice big circles, everybody. Nice big circle. Come to neutral. Take the left arm forward just a little bit more and then make it a bit more of an intense circle. Just a bigger sweeping range of motion. And take it in both directions as well. And come back to head neutral, left hand back, right arm forward. Other directions, let's do both sides. Back to neutral. Left arm forward, so both are forward, and I'm going to just do the same thing. Bring a big circular movement to it. Make it as big of a sweeping circle as you can. Opposite direction as well, both directions. And then we come back and find a seated position. So back to sit, everybody, on or off the block, whatever you like. I'm going to go onto a block. Okay, good stuff. Cross your legs. Resting the hands on top of your legs. You're going to turn your head to the right and my left, your right. Drop the ear to the shoulder. Look up at the ceiling, peek at the ceiling, and then do a full head circle, super slow. As you look up, 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 all the way to the other side, then you're gonna start to look down. Drag your chin across your chest. We're gonna do this 3 times in each direction, so super slow, half speed. All the way up and around. When you've done your 3, we're going to switch the direction and go to the other side. Take the head over to the other side, my right, your left. Drop the ear to the shoulder, look up, and then do the circle in the other direction. Notice any crunchy crunchies in the neck, which will go away if you keep doing this. And we go back to center position. Okay, hands come together, thumbs up to the third eye. We look up, take a nice big breath, and we bow forward, and we bow to each other for sharing the space and energy. I wish you all a great Sunday. Namaste. Yoga practice is over for today. Great job, you guys. You're all done. Good stuff. Thank you, everybody online. Thanks to you guys here. We are all good to go, and you've got your Sunday ahead. Thanks, everybody.
It was awesome. Thanks, Lou.
Thank you. We'll see you guys tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. Thank you.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, bye-bye. Have a great day.